प्राणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहना भवतु, सहनौ भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्गणेशाय नमः। सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्गतित्वनिर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं मत्तोऽन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। सो वी वेर लुकिंग एट दि इनिशियली एट दि मंगलाचरण दि पूर्वपक्ष देर समाधान देर एंड नाउ इन दि लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ वी सॉ दैट दि ग्रंथ महिमा इज बिगन एंड इन दि ग्रंथ महिमा देर वॉज अ वर्ड अविद्यादि अखिल अनर्थ निवृत्त्या केवल अद्वितीय चिन्मात्र रूप धीर परमानंदम आपनोति। परमानंद इज मोक्ष, सो वन अटेन्स मोक्ष दुख निवृत्ति एंड सुख प्राप्ति इज मोक्ष, देयर बाय अविद्यादि अखिल अनर्थ निवृत्ति। अदर देन दि अविद्या अस्मिता राग द्वेष एंड अभिनिवेश विच इज डिस्क्राइब्ड इन योगशास्त्र एज क्लेशास। We also have the triad of Vedanta, which I had mentioned as avidya, kama, karma. So there was a question on how can karma be included there as anartha, because through vihita karma, nitya naimittika karma, one gets chitta shuddhi and thereby it becomes a sadhana towards jnanotpatti and thereby sadhana towards moksha. It is true, but the triad is mentioned there itself as avidya, kama, karma is paramparaya, thereby avidya which leads to kama and kama which leads to karma, that is anartha. So that's one way to look at as the nitya naimittika karma, which is for chitta shuddhi, does not has kama at its basis, thereby that is anyway excluded in this triad. But even if you include it, by itself it cannot lead to moksha, because even if it generates punya, punya is also a trap for a sadhaka. Unless there is jnanotpatti, this punya, which nityanaimittika punya, nityanaimittika karma janya punya or karma yoga janya punya, same meaning, counters the pratyavaya dosha. When it is done for chitta shuddhi, it generates chitta shuddhi, all right, but chitta shuddhi is not the goal. The goal is moksha, which is jnanena. Thereby, the prarabdha countered in this janma may keep one away from quite a large amount of dukkha, possible. However, another janma cannot be countered because another janma will come about because of sanchita karma being there. Sanchita karma is not countered. Only prarabdha, which is not conducive to sadhana or conducive to moksha purushartha or even conducive to anything else which is good, sukha, for that there is a badaka due to prarabdha, earlier papa, which is acting out now, and that alone is countered by the nitya naimittika karma. It does not generate fresh punya. It does not doing it does not generate any fresh papa either. Thereby, karma is included as anartha. So moving on, there is a question to this Purva Paksha. Nanu. So Nanu, प्राचीनोद्ग्रन्थेषु सूत्र तद्भाष्य वार्तिकादिषु किम् इति सो किमिति अयम् अपूर्वो ग्रन्थो अधुना विरच्यते इति चेत् न सो ऑब्जेक्शन इज दिस ग्रंथ दैट यू आर क्लेमिंग टू बी मोक्ष साधना व्हाई वुड एनीवन पिक दिस अप और व्हाई शुड एनीवन पिक दिस अप बिकॉज देर आर सो मेनी प्राचीन ग्रंथास सूत्रास क्रिएटेड बाय भगवान व्यास भाष्य भगवान भाष्यकार वार्तिका भगवान सुरेश्वर आचार्य सो मेनी आर देर आदिपदेन सो मेनी संप्रदाय कृत सो मेनी वर्क्स आर देर तो सत्सु अनेक प्राचीन ग्रंथेषु प्राचीन उद्ग्रंथेषु सूत्र भाष्य वार्तिकादिषु किमिति अयम अपूर्वः ग्रंथः अधुना विरच्यते इति चेत् व्हाई इज दिस पर्टिकुलर ग्रंथः नीडेड एट ऑल व्हाई डू यू इवन कंपोज सच अ ग्रंथः इज अ क्वेश्चन टू द ऑथर इति चेत् न इट इज नॉट सो दैट ओनली बिकॉज सम आर एग्जिस्टिंग यू शुड नॉट क्रिएट दैट इज इन ट्रू तेषाम् अत्यंत प्रौढोत्तमाधिकारिकत्वेन मन्दानाम् उपकाराय अस्य साफल्यात् सो तेषाम् तेषाम् सूत्रभाष्य वार्तिक इत्यादि इत्यादि ग्रन्थानाम् अत्यंत प्रौढ उत्तमाधिकारिकत्वेन इट इज नॉट ईजी टू अंडरस्टैंड सूत्र दैट इज द रीजन भाष्य हैज बीन रिटन इवन दी भाष्य ऑन उपनिषद्स आर डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड बृहद इज सो वास्ट इट इंक्लूड्स एवरीथिंग बृहदारण्यक ऑन दैट वार्तिका हैज बीन रिटन बाय भगवान सुरेश्वराचार्य वार्तिका इटसेल्फ इज सम 12,000 ऑड श्लोकास 12,000 ऑड श्लोकास एंड 10% ऑफ दोज इन इन दी In the Upodghata itself, Sangati Bhasha itself has so many Vartikas. It is not easy to understand. And even if it is easy to understand, it is, I mean, for some it is easy to understand, people cannot stay in it. Because a lot of Chitta Shuddhi being lacking. One may not be able to understand the intricacies, and even if one understands the intricacies, this didn't stay with you. We keep on forgetting what is the tarka used or what is the Shruti Pramana quoted to land on this. Thereby, Samshaya keeps on popping up again. Therefore, Tesham Atyanta Prouda Uttama Adhikarikatvena. There is, it is a Prouda Grantha. Lot of things which are used are assumed. There is an assumed qualification, adhikarikatvena. Adhikari is also adhikari in the sense of the varnashrama and sadhakatvam, the sadhana chatushtaya sampatti. This is assumed, but praudha, where also the qualification in terms of what has the person studied, there is an assumption in the orthodoxy. That Vyakrana Shastra, Nyaya Shastra, and Purva Mimamsa Shastra has been studied. People jump to Uttara Mimamsa, Vedanta is Uttara Mimamsa. Without Purva Mimamsa, without any karma, people jump to Upanishad. Oh, Upanishads are direct means to moksha, Vedanta. I am a Vedantin. They give up the karma kanda wholesale, including Nitya Naimittika karma. They say karma is not going to contribute anyway, anartha, avidyadi, is all this is anartha. Anartha is said to someone who is ready for moksha, one who has reached to certain point where he is doing karma for moksha perhaps, but after reaching a certain point, he knows that karma cannot give me moksha. Yadyat kritakam tadanityam. He understands that is the praudavada. Yadyat kritakam tadanityam. If one understands that, then the karma drops off, he takes to sannyasa. परीक्षलोकान कर्मचितान ब्राह्मणो निर्वेदम आयात ऑल दिस श्रुति व्हेन ही लिसन्स टू दैट देयर इज वैराग्य बिकॉज ही रिकलेक्ट्स एवरीथिंग दैट ही हैज डन इन एंटायर लाइफ एंड नथिंग दैट ही हैज डन हैज गिवन हिम नित्य आनंद, देयर बाय कर्म कैनॉट बी द मीन्स टू मोक्ष, सो ही विल ड्रॉप एवरीथिंग होलसेल टू दैट पर्सन. इट इज सेड दैट दिस अविद्या काम कर्म इज अनर्थ, जस्ट बाय लिसनिंग ओ कर्म इज अनर्थ, लेट मी ड्रॉप नित्य नैमित्य कर्म एंड डू एवरीथिंग दैट आई वॉन्ट, दैट इज नॉट वॉट इज सेड. इट इज ओनली डिनाइड एज अ मोक्ष साधन, दैट टू साक्षात, इट इज साक्षात साधना फॉर चित्त शुद्धि. सो प्रौढ़ मीनिंग द पूर्व मीमांसा एस्पेक्ट एंड अदर्स आर एज्यूम्ड व्हेन अ पर्सन इज स्टडिंग उपनिषद. इन द ऑर्थोडॉक्स इट इज एज्यूम्ड, देयर बाय व्हेन भगवान भाष्यकार सेज समथिंग ही मे जस्ट हिंट समथिंग, ही मे जस्ट हिंट एज्यूमिंग दैट यू नो, ही विल कोट पार्ट ऑफ द उपनिषद, ही विल कोट पार्ट ऑफ द मंत्र इन कॉन्टेक्स्ट. How it fits into the context is the role of the acharya teaching or the tikakaras etc. But even without that, one may be able to understand if that person is qualified enough in terms of the tarka used, in terms of the quotation given by karma, what is the example given, how it fits in. Thereby a lot of assumption is there, and adhikarittvam is adhikarikatvena. So adhikarittvam is assumed as sadhana chatushtaye sampanna saha adhikari. A lot of viveka vairagya shamadamadi shatka, and then alone there is mumukshuttvam. Mumukshuttvam should be tivra. Tivra mumukshuttvam is considered as adhikara, leading to adhikara for study of Upanishads. So it's not easy to understand. It is very easy to misunderstand and become a new Vedantin if one directly approaches Upanishads. Therefore, mandanam upakaraya. Mandanam does not mean manda buddhi in that sense. Manda buddhi has a very different connotation in the worldly, in the vernacular. But mandanam is those who are slow. Those who are slow, why they are slow? Because the buddhi is not tivra. Why is buddhi not tivra? Chitta shuddhi is lacking. Because buddhi can become tivra only when chitta is shuddha, the antakkarana can play the role of the buddhi more than the manaha. Or getting trapped in chitta, which brings in smriti, and one gets trapped in thinking about yesterdays and tomorrows, planning tomorrows and losing time on yesterdays, but not staying in the now, unable to analyze, do viveka of atma and atma. Thereby viveka is impossible. Most of the viveka is an afterthought. That shouldn't be the case. Thereby mandanam upakaraya asya saphalyat. This grantha is created for those who may not have adhikara in Upanishads or may not understand the intricacies of the Bhashya and the Vartika ityadi granthas. Thereby, this approach will help them reach the goal. It is, moksha is not denied to anyone. But to think that I should get moksha only in this way, that insistence may not lead people to moksha. Thereby, considering those set of people, including those who have adhikara, it may help, and those who do not have adhikara in the Prouda Granthas, there this grantha will do hand holding, thereby saphalyat. Satsu api anekeshu bhasha grantheshu pancha bhashatma bodhadishu vina vichara sagaram. Without vichara sagara, pancha bhashatma bodhadishu, there are some categories of bhasha granthas. Let's not focus there, but there's some set of granthas. I am also not clear of pancha bhasha, what are these. So pancha bhasha atma bodhadishu, atma bodha is mentioned, but atma bodha is not the atma bodha created by Bhagavan Shankaracharya, not Bhagavad Padacharya's grantha. It is some grantha which is maybe in different bhashas also, but bhasha grantha, they are called as they seem to be called as bhasha grantha. I tried to search around, I didn't get much out of this. So bhasha granthesu pancha bhasha atma bodha. So the atma bodha here is not the title, but we should take it as those which help understanding the atma. So pancha bhasha atma bodha adishu vina vichara sagaram, or there may be something titled so also, vina vichara sagaram. Now vichara sagaram, here we have seen it is a manana grantha. So vina vichara sagaram swatma vishayaka sarva samshayan anivartiran. Thereby, even if we study this Atma Bodhadi, all these Pancha Bhasha, whatever granthas, we can take everything that is there, these are prakarana granthas. Let's consider these as prakarana granthas, whereas the earlier ones are sutra, bhashya, prasthanatraya. So prasthanatraya plus prakarana granthas. Now prakarana granthas are also there. So you can take any prakarana grantha. All of these prakarana granthas are also created. Atma bodha, which Bhagavad Padacharya created, also can be taken. Viveka Chudamani, so many granthas, Digdrishya Viveka, Panchadashi, all these are there. So without Vichara Sagara, Swatma Vishayaka Sarva Samshayana Nivartiran. However, these granthakaras have created something which will help us understand. They are also for the same reason that Proud and Uttamadhikaris alone may find Upanishads leading them to moksha quite soon. Others will have difficulty. That is the reason they are created. But among those also, some are meant for Uttamadhikaris, even there, or Madhyamadhikaris. For example, some Tarka used in Panchadashi, it is not easy to understand. So, or somewhere there is Samanvaya done between yoga and ninth chapter. It is easy to misunderstand. These are possible. So therefore, Panchabhasha, all the other granthas where the author, earlier granthas, there the adhikarityam is lacking in the sadhaka. That is the reason we need prakarana granthas. Now in prakarana granthas also what happens? Prakarana granthas are also many. There are some which are written by great Vedantins who are themselves have, it's Anubhava Siddha, Vidvat Anubhava Siddha, which is in line with Shruti. They are the granthas which may lead to moksha if the sadhaka is also Madhyama Adhikari. But what happens is that there are some granthas which have just popped up, somebody studied something and then they start writing prakarana granthas. We as laymen cannot make out the difference. We pick up some book, we see, oh, great title, a great jnani, somebody talks about it, some shishya praises. We pick up that book and we say that, oh, my journey is done, I found a guru. None of that is going to happen. Why? Because he says, yata na nivartiran, saunshaya, sarva saunshaya na nivartiran. They won't take away the sarvas, all the saunshayas, all the doubts, because the author himself may not have resolved all his doubts. Or even if the author has resolved, he has not presented it, giving benefit of doubt. Let's say the author had jnana, but still he has not been able to present it because sampradaya training lacking. He is not able to handle the contradictions well, or say something which can be easily misunderstood. He uses some words which can have different meanings and people misunderstand, because they, in their particular languages, there are some ideas, and in another language, there is another idea. Sanskrit has been corrupted through various languages. There are rudi arthas in various languages. They hold good there and it may cause some confusion. So, yatha kechana granthakaraha shravana matram krutva bhasha grantham rachayamasu. Here, shravana is manana asiddha shravana. There is no manana done at all. When some shravana is done, somebody, you know, says that, okay, I can make a lot of money maybe. We don't know what the idea is, but it is said that granthakara shravana matram krutva bhasha grantham rachayamasu. They may think that, or may they may even get it, but they may not be able to explain others how to do manana, because they may not need manana. So we will give benefit of doubt. We'll say that the author was realized, but he did not know the right way to teach, because he did not see any other, he does not know any other way, he does not need any other way. He had enough chitta shuddhi of earlier janma. Shravana itself, some shravana triggered, and then he got led to moksha because there was no obstacle. However, masses need manana and nididhyasana. They need to be taught how to do manana and nididhyasana, which the author himself not know, because he didn't need it. Thereby, shravana matram krutva bhasha grantham rachayamasu. He may create some grantha in some language. Tataha tadgata vishyaha kechana shastranusarino na bhavanti. He may say something which may be contradictory to the Shruti because he has done some shravana. He does not know what all Upanishads say, so it may be contradictory to other Upanishads. These will definitely not lead to moksha. क्वचित शास्त्रार्थ वैपरीत्यं च उपलभ्यते, देर कैन बी समथिंग कंप्लीटली कॉन्ट्राडिक्टरी, इट मे नॉट बी इन लाइन विद शास्त्र एंड इट मे बी कॉन्ट्राडिक्टरी एट एंड सम प्लेसेस, सम शास्त्रास मे बी कॉन्ट्राडिक्टरी ऑल्सो. दीज विल नॉट लीड टू मोक्ष, दे विल लीड टू मोर एंड मोर कन्फ्यूजन. सो स्वयं मूढ़ अन्यान मोहयति, ही हिमसेल्फ इज कन्फ्यूज, ही विल कन्फ्यूज अदर्स. He may not be confused in terms of the in his own Atmajnana, but to explain to others, if someone has a question, he can't resolve it. He may give some mystical answer. It is very difficult for the others to follow. So it may be contradictory also. And people bring this to the table. They bring to the Vedanta table on discussion. Oh, my guru says this. There is no background to the guru as to, the guru may be Siddha, that is all right. We don't question the guru Shraddha, guru is Siddha for that person. But to bring that to the table and say that my guru says this, so Upanishad is wrong, is sahasamatram. It is foolish. The person who is studying under that guru, so to say study, or studying his works, himself does not benefit and he goes out and harms. The other seekers also are harmed. Because they get lost on the way. अपरे केचन स्वल्पशास्त्राभ्यास मात्रेण भाषा ग्रंथान रचयामासु. Others have done some study, same issue, स्वल्पशास्त्राभ्यास मात्रेण. So Shravana also may not be Siddha, or Shravana is there, some manana grantha they have studied, does not lead to moksha. तत्र वेदांतार्थस्य समग्रस्य अनुक्तत्वात् न तैहि निःसंशय ज्ञानम् उदेति. Thereby, the jnana will not be nissamshya. It will be ridden with doubts. We may not know that we have doubts. If someone comes up with a doubt, then Pujya Swamiji used to say, the person who is asked this doubt, he owns up that doubt. He is not able to answer. That is not needed. You are not able to answer, it's okay. But you should be convinced that this Advaita Tattva is the only way out. There is no other way out. This person not able to answer the question to the other, not able to answer to oneself, owns up the question, that doubt becomes his own. Thereby, it will not lead to jnana. So, nissamshyam jnana na udeti. Asmin vichara sagare tu vedantartha samarmakaha samagrataya shastranusarana pratipadyante. The author says that here in this grantha, because he has studied in the sampradaya, he was a vidwan who has studied, who had a wide base of study, and thereby the foundation was so strong that vichara sagare tu vedantartha samarmakaha. He knew that where are these, you know, issues. Looking at the teaching as given and looking at the shishya varga also, where do sadhakas face the issue? Where are the marmakas? Where are these, you know, they say painful points? Where are these difficult points? What is the difficulty each and everyone faces? Not everyone faces the same thing, but their category of people, they'll face this kind of a problem. The others will face this kind of a problem. Thereby, along with the marmasthana, along with these difficult issues, they have been described and resolved samagrataya, completely shastranusarana. All of this is resolved by the shastra, because Shastra is so vast that it caters to all kinds of sadhakas. Thereby, the Grantha is not focused to only one kind of sadhaka. It caters to all kinds of sadhakas with various ways, using the right tools for the right people. Otherwise, you know, if you have a hammer, everything looks like a nail. So, the one who has only this ekadesha, has only this ekadeshi, who knows only one way, he will be hammering only from one side. The sadhaka gets nothing. Sadhaka is asking something, the acharya is saying something else. He says, no, you come here and understand. He does not go down to the level of the sadhaka. The guru should be able to go down to the sadhaka, because shastra allows that. Shastra has Advaita Shastra. The Shruti is so beautiful, so compassionate. Bhagavan Bhashyakara elsewhere says, like, Shatahishe Hiteshini, like the hundreds and thousands of parents also, he says. So compassionate that the Shruti comes down to the level of the sadhakas through prakriya bheda, gives various prakriyas, does hand holding, gives reality to this prapancha which is mithya, but still you see it, yes, it is there. How is it created? It will tell you all sorts of stories of how it is created. Then slowly take you with karya karana prakriya, slowly take you further and show mithyatvam so that it grows upon you. You are not shocked out of place. Like in Tantra, they give you a shock. So that with a hope that you will, you know, fall out of this this samsara. Like launched out of. Nothing of that sort. It is slowly you are taken. And then when you are ready, then the carpet underneath is pulled. When you are ready. Not in the beginning. Otherwise, it will become new Vedanta. Thereby, asmin vichara sagratu Vedanta artha samarmakaha samagrataya shastranusarana pratipadyante. They are revealed as per the shastra. Sarvatra shastra avirodhena. Shastra avirodhena cha atma jnana upayogi vishayaha saprapancham nirupyante. And also there is no contradiction. If some tools are used which we have not come across, they are useful to atma jnana and they are not opposed. They are all elaborated, but none of these oppose the shastra. Tasmad ayam eva sarvebhyo vedanta granthebhya uttamottamah. So he claims that this grantha, because of its complete, this approach of catering to everyone and this broader approach, taking care of all types of sadhakas and using tools in the right manner based on shastras, not contradictory shastras, thereby uttamottama, this is the best grantha. Everything is available in one place. Nasti asya samam granthantaram. Arthavada, we can take arthavada, it is an advertisement. Advertisement need not be false. We are used to false advertisements. Advertisements can be true as well. It is to attract people so that they get benefit of being born as a human being. So sadhana chatushtay nirupanam. This is the focus here of this chapter now. Anubandha chatushtayam, the fourfold chatushtaya. First anubandha chatushtaya. And then sadhana chatushtaya. So anubandha chatushtaya is the grantha, vishaya. What is the vishaya? What is the prayojana? What is the, who is the adhikari? Who has that adhikari should have sadhana chatushtaya sampatti? And how are they connected to each other? That is the focus now. So anubandha chatushtayam adhikari vishaya prayojana sambandhanam anubandha iti nama. What is anubandha? Anubandha is the adhikari, vishaya, prayojana and sambandha. These four put together are called as anubandha. Adhikari, qualified, vishaya, subject matter. Prayojana is the phala, the result. Sambandha are the connection between these. Sarvasya hi shastrasya karmano vapikasya chit yavat prayojanam noktam tavat tatkena grihyate iti vachanat. Due to the statement like this, what is the statement here? The statement is sarvasya hi eva hi shastrasya karmanaha va api kasyachit. Whether you take karma or any shastra, all shastra, sarva can be any or can be all also. You pick up any shastra or any karma, yavat prayojanam na uktam. Unless you are told, hey, you do this. Okay, shraddha is different matter. You do this, you do it. But it is told, what will you get if you do something? What will you get if you study some particular shastra? So result should be mentioned. What will I get out of it? There is swartha. If someone tells you some karma, you do it. Say guru tells you do this. You don't question. If it is shraddha, shishya has shraddha in the guru, then he may not question. But what is his prayojana? His prayojana is that the grace of guru. So grace of guru is the prayojana. He may not have the karma prayojana. What that karma brings about, he does not care. Guru has said, do this, he'll do it. But he is interested in the grace. So there also prayojana is there. Swartha is always there. Without that, Purva Mimamsaka say that prayojana manuddishya mandopina pravartate. Without looking at the prayojana, even a manda who does not know other things, still he'll know what will I get out of this. So there has to be a prayojana. This is different for when a person sadhaka grows as a karma yogi, it's a different matter altogether. We are not looking at the maturity there, but then it is said, it is a kaimuttika nyaya. If a manda won't do it, then why would, while someone who knows that I have to utilize my time wisely, why will he engage in some shastra study if he does not know the prayojana? Thereby, yavat prayojanam na uktam. As long as the prayojana is not told, tavat tat kena grihyate. Who will pick it up? Who will pick up that karma or any shastra? Iti vachanat prayojanadi jnanabhave vivekinam granthe pravruttyanupapattehe tadangabhuto anubandha pratham nirupyate. First, this prayojana, this pravritti anupapatte, since nobody will pick up the grantha, even the vivek is vivekinam granthe pravritti anupapatte without knowing what prayojana ityadi, the chatushtaya, anubandha chatushtaya, therefore, first tadangabhuta anubandha Anubandha pratham nirupyate. So Anubandha, which is to be revealed first, thereby Adhikari is mentioned. Adhikari nirupanam. Adhikari lakshanam. What is the, who is the Adhikari? Nisargataha eva sarvesham antakkarane. Sorry, not Nisargata, Nisargata. So here, yeah, Nisargataha eva sarvesham antakkarane मल विक्षेप आवरणात्मक दोष त्रयम आस्ते मल विक्षेपण आवरण मल विक्षेपण आवरण इज नैसर्गिक सर्वेशाम इट इज सेड निसर्गतः नैसर्गिक सर्वेशाम अंतकरणे इन द अंतकरणा मल विक्षेपण आवरण इज देयर. व्हाट इज मल? मल मल इज सेड टू बी मलम नाम पापम. Mala is papa, says the Tippana there. Mala is papa. So papa is, without papa we won't get janma also. Without punya also we won't get janma. But we have seen that the manushya janma is 50-50% of papa, close to 50-50% of punya and papa. Devatatvam is when you have punya, lot of punya, almost close to 100%, not 100%. There is papa for devatas also. And a lot of papa, very less punya, will lead to Pashu Janma, Pashu Pakshi Janma. Thereby, mala is there for everyone. Vikshepa, avarna. So, vikshepa and avarna are also there. We don't know our swarupa avarna. We know ourselves as something else. There is adhyasa, therefore vikshepa. And thereby, subject-object division and the samsaranam. This is the doshatraya. Definitely doshatrayam aste, it is there for everyone and it is but natural. Unless one works on it, they will continue to be. Samsara will not go away on its own. We can't wish it away. Nishkama karmanushthanena antakkaranastha malarupa dosha nivritti. How is mala taken away? Mala is taken away nishkama karmanushthana is karma yoga without expecting results. Initially, we can't give up the results because it is already said, Prayojana Manuddishya, Mandopina Pravartate. Then, why will I do Nishkama Karma? This will be the question. So, there is a contradiction between Mimamsaka's perspective of Prayojana Manuddishya, Mandopina Pravartate, and Nishkama Karmanushthana is the Siddhanta for Chitta Shuddhi. But how will I become Nishkama? How will I do Nishkama Karma? I will do the Anushthana only when I know that I will get a bigger result out of this, which is Chitta Shuddhi, which will lead to Jnana, which will lead to Moksha. So I have to give up the smaller for the bigger. I have to make a compromise now so that I get something much, much, much better in comparison to this small result, which is anitya ananda. Some prayojana is a resultant, but if I give that up, I'll get something better. Only then I'll drop it. So nishkama karmanushthana. So initially it is said, you offer the results unto the Lord. At least do that. Consume it. You expect a result, consume it, but offer it to the Lord. So prasada buddhi. Then you offer the karma unto the Lord. Ishwara arpana buddhi. Over a period of time, that itself will give you enough to understand that I don't need any of this, none of this stays with me. So person can become a real karma yogi. Bhagavan Bhashyakara says in Gita, Ishwara, Ishwaro me tushyatu. That also one, the itimati, that also should be dropped. Even that Ishwara Prityartham should go in the long run. Initially, Chitta Shuddhyartham, Ishwara Prityartham, Chitta Shuddhyartham. After that, not even that, only for moksha. Then, even not for moksha, that's a much, much, much later, because doing something for moksha is possible only when one has not got jnana. Once jnana udaya happens, then there is no possibility of even assumption of bandha. Thereby, I am doing it for moksha. Bhagavan Sringeri Acharya says that earlier, Abhinav Vidyarthi Mahaswamiji used to say that even that expectancy of moksha, in the end you have to drop off, because otherwise you are giving reality to bondage. Bondage is not real. But this is paramparaya. Initially nishkama karma, and nishkama karma anushthana will do what? This antakrana mala nivritti, mala dosha, mala rupa dosha nivritti. It will take away the mala, which is papa. So nishkama karma anushthana will bring about punya, which will counter the papa, thereby mala will go away. That's the first dosha. Upasanaya vikshepasya, vikshepasya kim? Vikshepa rupa dosha nivritti. So vikshepasya nivritti, vikshepa will go away through upasana. Upasana itself is becoming very, very limited in the sampradaya, because people jump to jnana kanda and skip away all the upasana portion. The guru himself does not know, shishya won't know. In sampradaya it is outside of orthodoxy, it is lost. In orthodoxy, upasana is taught. Even the nitya naimittika karma is lost. So nitya naimittika karma, along with that, there is upasana also. Lot of people do not do dhyana because dhyana itself is lost. This dhyanam. So you start with dhyanam, that is lost. Even if dhyana is there, it is just read as a mantra, as a shloka. But there is no dhyana done. That dhyana is also a karmanga. It is an upasana. There are independent upasanas also. Upanishads themselves are full of these. These upasanas are before the jnana, also after jnana. Both are there. If jnana itself has not resulted in moksha, then upasana needs to be continued because vikshepa is there. Otherwise, pre-jnanotpatti for sadhaka to become uttama adhikari, upasana is prescribed. Then, yasya nishkama karma upasana abhyam mala vikshepa yoho nivruttau api swasvarupavar avaraka ajnanam na nivruttam. Yascha pushkala sadhana chatushte sampanna sa adhikari. So where do we stand? Yasya nishkama karma upasana abhyam, through nishkama karma and upasana. Mala vikshepa yoho nivritta vapi. Mala and vikshepa has gone. Papa has gone. And this vikshepa has gone. One does not consider oneself as, you know, completely what is projected. Thereby, because what is projected, raga, dvesha, ityadi, all of these one gets carried away by, then those are vikshepas. Otherwise, this vikshepa, if one can control all this, then one becomes an adhikari. That is by shamadama ityadi and upasana. Without shamadama, anyway, upasana will also not be possible. Thereby, those who have mala, which has reduced, and they have reduced mala, we can't say completely gone, papa, and vikshepa under control, then mala vikshepayoho nivruttau api. Even after that, swasvarupa avaraka ajnanam na nivruttam. How will this go without jnana? Yes, there is shravana going on, or shravana which has been done in earlier janma may just trigger. This is the reason that we see some people say that jnana is not needed for moksha. They cannot be faulted for that, because they don't see that particular guru taking Jnanopadesha in this Janma, we can't fall the Guru also, because that Guru does not have Siddhi enough to know as that he has had Shravana in the earlier Janma. Otherwise, it is impossible. But it is possible that just by the Mala and Vikshepa Nivritti, the earlier Jnana, to which this was an obstacle, these Mala and Vikshepa, they have gone, and the earlier Jnana from the earlier Janma may trigger. Thereby, Ajnana Nivritti may happen. Even without Shravana in this Janma, something may trigger. It's a possibility. Therefore, and this is a very rare category. For masses, what will happen? Swasvarupa avaraka ajnanam na nivruttam. These are the masses. And then yascha pushkala sadhana chatushtaya sampannaha, has enough, not just bits and pieces, but has sadhana chatushtaya sampatti saha adhikari. Then what is the sadhana chatushtaya? You have introduced a new word. Sadhana chatushtaya, we know this, but nitya nitya vastu vivekaha, iha mutra phalabhoga viragaha, shamadamadi shatka sampat, mukshuttam chaiti. So nitya and anitya, between nitya and anitya vastu, one should have a viveka. Nitya vastu brahma eka, ekam. Brahma alone is the nitya vastu. Anitya is everything else. This is the viveka, discrimination. Iha amutra, here and hereafter, whatever phala is there, I do not have any craving for that. Thereby, I become a vairagi, viragaha, phala bhoga viragaha, here or hereafter, in swarga or any other loka. It can be in this loka itself, but places which I do not know, they can be considered as loka, because lokyante iti lokaha anubhavaha. So anubhava, which I have not had, I hear whatever someone says that, okay, this particular country has so much to offer. You have nothing, you know. Why don't you go there and settle down and enjoy? That is also amutra, elsewhere. Shamadamadi shatka sampat shamadama uparati titiksha shraddha samadhana. That is the sixfold wealth of the sadhaka. We'll see more here. And then mukshuttam chaiti. Mukshuttam is only possible after this. Otherwise, this mukshuttam does not stay. This is not this. Mumukshuttam is what? Mukshoho bhava mukshuttam. And who is mumukshu? Moktum ichchuhu. So moktum ichchuhu, there the desire is, should be not moksha also, only moksha only. Only when it becomes tivra, it leads to moksha. That sampatti is the last to really acquire. One will become a mumukshu only when all of these earlier are earned in good measure. And then each of these are inquired into, we'll see in the next part. सुखम नित्यम सप्रकाशम व्यापकम नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानम बुद्धि बोध्यम बुद्धेर दृक्यत्व निर्मलम अपारम सर्व वेदांत वेद्यम प्रत्यक परम महः तदेवाहं नमत्वन्यत इति मे निश्चितामतिः उत्सद. Assume there are no questions. Are there any questions?
No.
Okay, so I'll see you in the next part. Namaste.
Pregunta.